Hello everyone, this is Abhabe Chukala from IHE Delft. This lecture video is on crop yield response to water. Many factors affect crop yield that includes inputs, the amount and timing of fertilizer and water, climatic parameters such as precipitation, temperature, and carbon dioxide concentration in the atmosphere, physical and chemical properties of soil, groundwater condition, the quality of the water, as well as whether the groundwater is shallow or not. Biotic factors that include weeds, diseases, and pests. Crop cultivar, whether the crop variety is improved or not. Under optimal conditions, the graph of crop yield response to water has different shapes. This depends on the variable in the x-axis. The variable in the x-axis is related to water uses, which can be seasonal irrigation, seasonal evapotranspiration, or seasonal transpiration. On the left is the graph of crop yield versus seasonal irrigation. It crosses the y-axis at a positive value, which corresponds to crop yield under rain-fed agriculture. This yield increases with the amount of seasonal irrigation and starts declining after certain amount, which is due to soil aeration problem, also called aeration stresses. In the middle is the graph of crop yield versus seasonal evapotranspiration. It crosses the x-axis at a positive value, and this x-intercept corresponds to soil water evaporation. On the right is the graph of crop yield versus seasonal transpiration, which is linear and passes through the origin. The graph of crop yield response to water use can be plotted for two variables on the x-axis. In this case, evapotranspiration and applied irrigation water. The applied irrigation water excludes the rainfall contribution. For higher x values, the graph of irrigation starts to deviate, also shift to the right compared to the graph of evapotranspiration. This horizontal shift corresponds to non-ET water fluxes, also called return flows, that includes percolation and runoff. DeWitt is among the pioneers to show the relationship between dry matter production in the y-axis and normalized transpiration in the x-axis, which is linear under optimal condition. In his study, transpiration was normalized by pan evaporation. DeWitt showed the linear relationship that passes through the origin to exist under optimal condition for different crops, that includes sorghum, wheat, and alfalfa. Recently, Stodito and Albrizzo showed a linear relationship to exist between above ground biomass in the y-axis and cumulative transpiration in the x-axis for different crops under two nitrogen levels, optimal and suboptimal. The linear relationship was maintained even after the transpiration was normalized by reference evapotranspiration, again under optimal condition and under those two nitrogen levels. The normalization by reference evapotranspiration, however, helps to cluster the crops into two categories based on their efficiency in their photosynthesis process. They are called C4 crops and C3 crops. C4 crops includes maize, sugarcane, and most of the cereal crops fall under C3 crops. The slope of above ground biomass and cumulative normalized transpiration is a conservative parameter called normalized water productivity. This parameter made core of the aquacrop model. Under each category of crop, that's C3 and C4, there are two boundary lines. The upper boundary corresponds to the optimal condition, while the lower boundary is under soil fertility stress. The above ground biomass versus transpiration, as well as above ground biomass versus cumulative of normalized transpiration graph, can be used as agronomic test for a data set that is assumed to be under optimal condition or under different fertility stresses. WAPOR is one of the remote sensing data sets on water consumption, production, and climate, which is hosted by FAO. The plot of above ground biomass versus transpiration, as well as above ground biomass versus normalized transpiration using WAPOR data, shows straight line passing through the origin, which is a confirmation that WAPOR data set for this particular crop area as well as season agronomically make sense. The graph of crop yield or biomass response to water use has different shapes. There are generally proved relationships under optimal and suboptimal fertility conditions. Crop yield is affected by many stress factors that can be categorized under biotic and abiotic stresses. So the variation in crop yield can be then due to temperature stresses, water and nutrient stresses, or aeration and salinity stresses, which can be called also abiotic stresses, or it could be due to weeds, diseases, and pests, which can be lumped as biotic stresses. Thank you very much for listening to the video lecture.